gorgeous best friend.
Hello, hello.
I gotta ask you a question today, okay?
Good, because I didn't read any today.
Okay, continue.
Okay, so let's pretend there's a best friend.
You.
There's a best friend and there's this guy.
Right.
And you know that they're both...
Wait. You're going too fast. There's a best friend, there's this guy. Who is this guy?
This guy, he's the perfect guy for your best friend. Like, their personalities match, their energies match, everything, they're good for each other.
Can I hook him up? I'm kidding.
There's a problem.
What's the problem?
Let's pretend that I'm dating that guy.
Wait.
Then what do? If you're dating the guy...
So you're dating a guy.
Yeah.
But you think that guy...
Is perfect for
is
my...
Is perfect for your best friend. But what if they don't feel that way about each other? Have they met?
No, they haven't met, but you know in your heart that, like, they would get along.
If they met?
And they'd be, like, perfect soulmates.
Okay. That's tricky. So I'm gonna put myself in this position, in your shoes or whatever. Yeah. So, I'm with a guy. And do I like this guy?
Yeah. Oh, wait, you don't know him yet.
No, like, I'm putting myself in your shoes.
Yeah, I like him. But I like him for my best friend.
And this is all fake, right? You don't like really.
No.
This is not a real situation.
Girl,
right?
I'm single.
Okay, yeah. Okay, I got it. So, I'm a girl dating this guy, and I really like him.
Yeah.
But every time I look at him, I feel like he would be perfect for my best friend.
Yes.
And my best friend and him haven't met yet.
Yes.
But I know that if they met, it would be like
magical,
unbelievable. You know, honestly, I'd let them meet. Okay, here's what I would do. I'm not saying I would give them to each other. I wouldn't be like, okay, yeah, go date my best friend. You're perfect for her. And I wouldn't tell my best friend, go date him. And I wouldn't put any ideas in anybody's head.
Yeah.
Like, oh, you know, my boyfriend's just like you. Then I wouldn't go tell her. Like,
yeah, then it's not
natural. I wouldn't
natural.
Tell him, like, oh, my best friend is just like you. I would just casually be like, hey, let's all hang out. Let's go bowling. Let's go doing whatever we're doing. And then I let what's meant to happen just happen. If they really are perfect for each other, if what I feel is accurate, why should I take it away from them?
Yeah.
I would be like, okay, you guys should be together then if you like each other. But what if they meet and they don't like each other? They're too alike. What if they don't like each other at all because they're exactly like each other? So, you know what I mean? Sometimes you need someone who's a little different. So, I don't know. It all depends. But I would definitely hang out. Damn, my car is
so...
Sorry.
Love what you said, though. Thanks for that.
Yeah, like, it's not a hard thing. I feel like people complicate things too much. But... That was a rapper, right?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Dude, this parking lot is not cutting
it. Fine, you're a great driver. I get you the bow.
Thank you, Tay Tay. I'm scared right now.
You got this, girl. You got this. You got this.
Okay, so I have an actual, like, I just have something to say about relationships now that we're talking about it, okay?
Yeah.
So, I've noticed a lot of failed relationships here, right?
Yeah.
At least in Chicago, like people that I've met. I've seen it a lot where when the girl, let's say the girl is taking care of the guy completely.
Yeah.
Emotionally, financially, she's taking care of him.
Yeah.
I've noticed that guy is so loyal to her. Like,
yeah.
He might be bad in other things, like he might be ungrateful, he might be mean. All of that aside, his loyalty. I'm talking about his loyalty.
Yeah.
He might be mean to her, right?
Mm-hmm.
But if she's doing everything for him, he's so loyal to her. Like, he won't even look at another girl, right?
Yeah, I know.
At the same time, I noticed guys that are taking care of their wives completely, financially, emotionally, in every way, you know, they tend to think that they could take care of more people. They always cheat.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying this, like, please, guys and girls, don't get offended. I'm just saying based on, like,
what I've seen so far around me.
Yeah.
Maybe it's different in freaking California, I don't know. But around me, when the girl is taking care of the guy is very loyal.
Yeah.
There might be other underlying issues, but I don't want to get into that. Right? And when the guy is taking care of the girl, they always usually, like, they're cheating. Like, they're also talking to other girls or looking at other girls or... Because, you know, they can, they think they can take care of more.
Yeah.
But you know which relationships I've seen succeed?
Which one?
When they're both taking care of each other. Yeah, that takes so a special true. Kind of teamwork.
Yeah.
And I don't mean just financially. I mean emotionally, too.
Yeah.
Like, they're both supporting each other emotionally. They're both financially supporting each other. When one can't do it, the other's doing it. When the other can't... Like, it's called teamwork.
Yeah.
It's very rare to find that. But every relationship where I've seen both of them trying, they're always the happiest. It's rare. They last longer. So all the weight shouldn't be on one person.
Exactly.
It shouldn't be on the girl to do it all just for loyalty. And it shouldn't be on the guy to do it all. You know? Just because he can and he's a guy. So, be equal. I guess that's my best advice. At least for Chicagoans. All you people in Chicago, if you want your relationship to last...
Teamwork makes the dream work.
Teamwork makes the dream work. Yes, very nice. All right, let's go, you guys.
Bye, guys.
I mean, bye. I'm taking them with me. Okay.